Hello children, in this session I explain section 2 of lesson number 2, Life at Hawthorne School. Hello children, in section 2 we have information about aliens meeting with Heidi and other students and also about her nature of behavior. After the walk, Heidi went to her room and found Aileen, the new people in a flurry of dresses, hats, slippers, books, gloves and suitcases. How do you do, Aileen? I'm Heidi, your classmate. In last section, we had seen the students had a walk with Miss Smith. After that, Heidi reached her room, found Aileen, the new people. She was surrounded by dresses, hats, slippers, books, gloves and suitcases. She was doing unpacking. She introduced herself to Aileen, saying that she was her roommate. How do you do? Aileen replied stiffly, not bothering to raise her head. May I help you with your things? Heidi offered, remembering that the headmistress had asked the girls to be especially kind to her. Aileen missed back in an unfriendly way. She did not even raise her head. She did not look at her. She continued her work of unpacking. Heidi asked her whether she wanted her help to arrange her things. Heidi also remembered that the principal had asked the girls to be kind to Aileen. No, thank you. I would much rather have this room to myself. Could you ask to be changed? Aileen demanded. I am afraid not, Heidi told her. The other girls have been here longer than I. They already have roommates. Aileen replied that she did not want her help and she asked whether she could change her room or not. Heidi said that it was not possible to change her room because the other girls had been there longer than Heidi and they had already roommates. How annoying! Aunt Aileen turned her back unsociably as she continued her unpacking. On the balcony, Heidi found Jeremy, Lissy and Annie and Eva. Aileen is here, she announced. Yes, what is she like? Asked Lissy. Tall, thin, with very black hair and green eyes, said Heidi. Is she nice? Asked Jeremy. Go in and see for yourself and then tell me what you think of her, Heidi responded. Aileen did not like her answer and she continued her unpacking without noticing Heidi. She was very rude. Heidi found Jeremy, Lissy, Annie and Eva on the balcony when she went outside. Heidi said that Aileen was there in the room. When Lissy asked about Aileen, Heidi said that Aileen was tall and thin. She had very black hair and green eyes. When Jeremy asked about whether she was nice, Heidi told them to meet Aileen directly and understand her nature. The four girls disappeared through the long doors leading into the room. Hello, Aileen, they said. So the four girls came to Aileen's room and wished her. They wanted to talk to her. Oh, hello. Why am I in the same room with that little peasant girl? The new girl stormed. But that is Heidi, protested Lissy. Who is Heidi? Demanded Aileen. Clara's friend spoke up Eva. The granddaughter of Uncle Arm up in the mountains, added Annie. She plays the violin beautifully, said Jeremy. When the four girls wished Aileen, Aileen wished them back. Then she expressed her dislike about Heidi, her new roommate. She said that she did not want to have Heidi, a peasant girl, as her roommate. Lissy did not like Aileen's rude remark about Heidi. She told Aileen to call her roommate as Heidi, not as a peasant girl. Eva said that Heidi was Clara's friend. Annie said that she was the granddaughter of Uncle Arm, who was living up in the mountain. Jeremy said that she played violin very beautifully. In this way, all the girls supported Heidi. Then, she's an artist, A peasant and an artist? How dreadful! Why couldn't I have a room with you? Asked Elin, turning towards Annie. Children, Elin could not believe the information given by the four girls. She said to them, how could a peasant girl be an artist? Then she asked Annie whether she could be her roommate. Impossible. Since I came 3 days ago, I have been afflicted with the companionship of Lizzie here. We argue all day long. She went on with a laugh, but I would not leave her for the world. Children, Annie replied that she was very happy and in good friendship with her roommate Lizzie, and she would never leave her. What a pity. And you? Asked Elin, turning to Eva. Me? Asked Eva. I am very happy rooming with Jemmy. I am big and she is little, so we balance each other perfectly. Anyway, Heidi is very nice and we all like her. Children, then Elin asked Eva whether she could be her roommate. Eva replied that she was very happy to have Jemmy as her roommate and balanced each other perfectly. She said that Heidi was nice and they all liked her. She does not please me, said Elin. That is just too bad, concluded Lizzie. But she left the room with a merry twinkle in her eyes. Heidi had been attacked and they all had an opportunity to defend her. Elin replied that she was not happy to have Heidi as her roommate. Lizzie said that Ellie's thinking was only bad and Heidi was a good girl. Saying this, she went outside the room. Lizzie was happy because they all had an opportunity to defend Heidi or support Heidi when she was attacked by Elin. Children, so I end this session here. Next section, I will explain in my next session. Okay, children?